I was like, he said, oh, hey, I got my picture taken. I said, that's not true.
How do you know?
That's worth
welcome, it. Everyone. Welcome, welcome.
We're
totally taking
forward out there.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Three, two, one. Even though I'm actually filming. Three, two, one. Thank you very much, guys. Awesome.
This is Debbie, just wishing for sunshine. We're all going to go outside and dance naked and wish for sunshine soon.
Well, I have already done that.
Oh, didn't know the Love Island cast was coming. Love it.
I'm offended.
Oh, work it, boys. Work those chairs. Come on, give me some wiggling. Let me see it. Come on. Oh,
energy.
Dude, on the end, it always just erupts out of you. What's that about? I'm impressed.
My boyfriend loves it.
I'll probably leave it down.
Yeah.
Do you like all those pictures on the wall?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Someone else.
Oh, that's gorgeous. Oh my gosh, that's freaking lush. Oh my gosh, seriously.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, that's so gorgeous. Perfect.
Thank you.
Yes, you guys.
Say cheese.
Hi.
It's your wedding day.
Going to season six is happening today.
Right, brother, he's a poser as well.
Going to the chapel and
after the ceremony, grab your bag if you want to.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking because otherwise.
Mon, your hair is unreal.
No, I'm gonna cut to after his wedding.
I can take
no, like this.
Yeah.
What?
Too much.
I can't.
Yeah, no, Steve just asked me. I just said it's literally just the weather. I'm really nervous.
Ah, you'll be fine. Yeah. You'll be all right.
No, I think it's gonna be wet.
Look, let's go pink.
I'll be all right.
Do you reckon? I wonder if my wife's probably safe.
Yeah. Be your own truth. Yeah. Yeah. Are we? Oh, did I get one? Oh, yeah, we did.
Just looking at each other for this.
Oh, that's so nice! Love anyone!
Legends. What did you do with video there, like?
I think there are quite a few options on that.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please be upstanding for the arrival of the bridal carpet? Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the lovely setting here at Plum Park, which has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of weddings. We are here today to witness and to celebrate the marriage of Kyle and Debbie. And on their behalf, may I thank you for joining with them in this, the celebration of their very special day. We hope that it will be a happy and memorable day for you all. Now, Debbie, would you like to put those lovely flowers down? In Northamptonshire, we have a very strange tradition. We do believe that brides and grooms have been introduced to each other. Yes, <my answer. laughs> You're allowed to stand closer and you are allowed to hold hands. If you think it would help. A little bit of moisture. My name is Anne, and on behalf of West Northamptonshire Registration Service, it's my very pleasant duty, it's my privilege to conduct your ceremony today. My colleague is Maureen, whom you've already met, and as the registrar, it's her responsibility to witness your marriage and to issue that essential paperwork. But before we can proceed with the wedding ceremony, I do have to ask that if any person here present knows of any lawful impediment why Kyle or Debbie may not be joined in matrimony, they should declare it now, regardless of any glares. Kyle, please state your full name.
Kyle Marcus Gibbings.
Thank you. Debbie, please state your full name.
Deborah Michelle Rhodes.
Kyle Marcus Gibbings and Deborah Michelle Rhodes, before you are joined in matrimony, it's my duty to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life, the exclusion of all others. It's a special union to provide love, care, support and friendship to each other throughout the joys and sometimes those difficulties that we know life can bring us. So I'm now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that to the best of your knowledge and belief, there is no lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. So Kyle, please repeat after me. I declare that I know.
I declare that I know.
Of no legal reason.
Of no legal reason.
Why I, Kyle Marcus Gibbings.
Why I, Kyle Marcus Gibbings.
May not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Deborah Michelle Rhodes.
To Deborah Michelle Rhodes.
Debbie. I declare that I know.
I declare that I know.
Of no legal reason.
Of no legal reason.
Why I, Deborah Michelle Rhodes.
Why I, Deborah Michelle Rhodes.
May not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Kyle Marcus Gibbings.
Kyle Marcus Gibbings.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle and Debbie have asked for a moment of reflection because there are loved ones who are unable to be with us today. We're going to have a little piece of music and a moment of quiet. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment has now arrived for Kyle and Debbie to contract their marriage before you, their witnesses, their families and their friends. These special words will join them together both formally and publicly. And although they've invited you all here to witness their marriage today, there are two specially designated witnesses I'm going to call forward. That Natalie and Craig, please step forward.
He has to be. And he forgot.
It's his mark. All you need to do is to stand
and listen to the words. The other people are going to speak to each other. And in a few minutes' time, we'll ask you to sign the register. Sign what used to be the register, the legal paperwork. To say that you... Ladies and gentlemen, can I ask that if you are able and it's comfortable for you to do so, please stand to join together to celebrate the marriage. And I'm going to ask you two to face each other, please. Join hands.
Yeah.
Kyle, I'm going to ask you a long question now, and I'm sure you're going to know the answer. Kyle, will you take Debbie to be your wedded wife, to share your life with her, to love, support, and comfort her, whatever the future may bring? I call upon these persons here present.
I call on these persons here present.
To witness that I, Kyle Marcus Gibbings.
To witness that I, Kyle Marcus Gibbings.
Do take thee, Deborah Michelle Wolds.
Do take thee, Deborah Michelle Wolds.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
Same question to you. Debbie, will you take Kyle to be your wedded husband? Share your life with him, to love, support and comfort him, whatever the future may be.
I will.
These words after me. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Deborah Michelle Wolds.
To witness that I, Deborah Michelle Wolds.
You take thee, Kyle Martha Gibbons. You take thee, Kyle Martha Gibbons.
Be my lawful wedded husband. Be my lawful wedded husband.
And you heard them, I do believe. We'll call you forward in a few minutes. Please take your seats. Please take your seats, everybody. However, don't make yourself too comfortable, Natalie. Because Kyle and Debbie have chosen a reading.
I did know about this.
I'm glad about that. Right. So if you'd like to step forward, I hope you've got... Oh, Mum's got it.
I have to print it for her. To love is to share life together, to build special plans just for two, to work side by side and then smile with pride as one by one dreams all come true. To love is to help and encourage with smiles and sincere words of praise. To take time to share, to listen and care in tender, affectionate ways. To love is to have someone special on whom you can always depend. To be there through the years, sharing laughter and tears as a partner, a lover and friend. To love is to make special memories of moments you love to recall, of all the good things that married life brings. Love is the greatest of all.
Thank you very much, Natalie. I think that's worth one.
Oh, thank you.
Traditionally, ladies and gentlemen, the wedding ceremony is marked by the exchange of rings. These rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love and are an outward sign of the lifelong promises that you are making to each other. May these rings remind you always of the vows that you pledged to each other today. And Cass, I do believe you have those rings. Now, Marcus, I thought there were two in that box.
There is
Kyle.
Two.
Yeah. There are two in the box. Yeah. Kyle, take the one that is destined for Debbie's ring. Take her left hand in your hand. That's the way. And put the ring on the tip of her finger, hold it there, and repeat these words rather than me. Let's say them together. Debbie, I give you this ring.
Debbie, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a token of our love.
And as a token of our love.
And slide it in onto the ring.
I promise to care for you, to trust and confide in you, and to be faithful to you always. I give you my love and friendship, my comfort and support. I promise to respect and cherish you through all that life may bring. These promises I make to you sincerely for the rest of my life.
You're finished.
You're trying
to do something here. Right. Hang on to his hand, Debbie, and put the ring on his third finger. That's the one. Hold it there, and repeat these words after me. Kyle, I give you this ring.
Kyle, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a token of our love.
And as a token of our love.
So, hang on to his hand.
I promise to care for you, to trust and confide in you, and to be faithful to you always. I give you my love and friendship, my comfort and support. I promise to respect and cherish you through all that life may bring. These promises I make to you sincerely for the rest of my life.
Well done. Families and friends of Kyle and Debbie, through the vows that they've made today, they are pledging themselves to each other for the years ahead, believing that whatever life may hold for them, they will share through the strength and the love that their marriage will bring. Today is a new beginning. It will form a milestone in your life, I do hope you will look back with joy, happiness, and maybe a little. Kyle Marcus Gibbings and Deborah Michelle Wolds, you have now made your declarations of marriage as prescribed by law, and through them have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of the registrar, your witnesses, your families and your friends assembled here today. And so it gives me great pleasure to pronounce that you are now joined together as husband and wife. Many congratulations and best wishes for a long and happy married life together.
Thank you. Please talk amongst yourselves, ladies and gentlemen. There will probably be a bit of music.
DJ.
Yes, that's why I got fat. Yes, that's why.
I'll be like, I used to be, I'm skinny before I got married.
Right, guys, that's amazing.
Just put your hand onto the edge of your left hand.
I can't write with my left.
We're only pretending. Kyle, can you pop your hand onto
the
edge?
Right, squeeze in, darlings. Yeah. Thank you. Nice lean.
All right, Ashley Cole on the end. Brilliant, brilliant. Oh no, my wife's photobombing it. Right, stand up, guys. That's my weird. A bit odd. There you go. Oh, that's better. Yes, guys, loving it. Amazing. Thank you. Perfect. Thank you very much.
And ladies and gentlemen, it really has been a pleasure and a privilege for Maureen and myself to conduct the ceremony here today, and just to be a little part of your special day.
Out front.
As the bride and groom exit the room, you will notice that she's on his left-hand side. This is because traditionally, ladies and gentlemen, and is very necessary here in Plum Park, she is on his left, and that leaves his sword arm free to defend his lovely bride. Ladies and gentlemen,
to defend her,
please be upstanding one more time.
Just captured for us.
And make a very welcome the newly married Mr. and Mrs. Gibbings.
Woo! Woo, 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 woo. Yes, you too. Yes. Oh, gorgeous. What an exit.
Am I going to take some photos, but we guess round to the front, Paddy, for your shots?
We do a confetti first, then a big group shot while everyone's out there after, is that alright?
Yeah.
Ledge.
I think that's what Debbie said.
Perfect.
Just because it's starting to look like it got a little bit overcast, I'm like, oh god, are we going to get a confetti shot?
Until five, we're fine, obviously.
I have to say, it's quite nice to have everyone outside and have this whole room for us.
How does it feel?
Amazing.
Good, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Yes.
I can't believe that I like walked through here absolutely fine and just burst into tears when
I saw everyone.
Yeah,
that was so cute.
Your mum's crying her eyes out.
What do you think of the dress, Carl?
Do you like your hairpin?
I did, yeah.
Did you make you laugh?
I didn't know what it was.
Oh, you're like, oh, she got me this weird thing.
I knew it was for something.
It's a tie pin. Carl likes Star Wars, his tie pin's got a link to the Death Star and back on it.
Did you watch Mandalorian?
And he's got cufflinks.
How good was that?
And he's got his friend to stand up.
Did she?
Yeah.
Oh. Right, squeeze in. Come on, arms around each other. Let's have a look.
I know. I've watched my nail. You're pulling my nail.
Just remember, it's attached to her skull, basically. So be careful. Don't pull it out. Oh, guys, seriously. They look good, don't they? Guys, 10 out of 10. Have a little kiss under the chandelier. Chandelier. One more time. Oh, yes.
You think you didn't want to kiss me?
They said more tongue.
I think... Debbie, come and stand here. Come and stand here, because there's really enough light pouring in there. So if you stand kind of facing towards me. Oh my gosh, darling. Seriously? Kyle, that's your wife. That's your wife, dude. Come and stand in behind her. So kind of come around this way. Get your arms right around her. Get your arms right around her. Oh, God. Come in really close. That's it. Oh, guys, seriously, what? That's one
for the mantelpiece.
Beautiful. Give her a little kiss on the cheek, Carl. Face cheek. That's it.
Face cheek.
In fact, you've got to give her 10 kisses anywhere but the lips. Go. go.
One, not two, that kind of video.
four, five. That was five. Keep going. Good.
Save two for later.
Kyle the woodpecker. Perfect.
No, you just have to.
Well, they're here. Okay. Yeah, facing that way, yeah. Right, guys, that's pretty good. So, have we got mums and dads in there? We have. Brothers and sisters, we have. Where is... Oh, yeah, that's fine. Dad, can you squeeze in next to mum, please? Good man. Come on, guys, make some room for him. That's it. Right, that's perfect. Now, guys, everyone at the back, can you come forwards and fill in those gaps a bit?
That was definitely like The Walking Dead. Okay, perfect.
Right, okay, let's have a look. Hey. Right, lovelies, looking this way for me, please. Let's have a look, you gorgeous bun. Oh my gosh, you all look amazing. Seriously? This is going on everybody's fridge. Perfect. Right, everybody, okay, that's pretty amazing. Wow, okay. See, I don't even need to look, you're all so gorgeous. Okay. Right, can we please have a big cheer on three? Hands in the air and everything. Are you ready? Hold on. Right, and one, two, three. It sounded good. Looked a bit rubbish. Okay, I want a bit more vigour, okay? Come on, guys, there's like 60 of us in one place. This is amazing. Come on, this is amazing. Right, are you ready? Give it some. Three, two, one. That's what I came here for. Yes. You beautiful bunch. Well done, everyone.
Right, look in this lane, you beautiful bunch.
Oh my good gracious. Wow, guys. Wow.
Who is the most photogenic family? We will soon find out. You guys are winning so far.
We're the first ones. What
car
school did you go to?
Right, I want everyone to give me a bit of a wiggle, including you in the chair now. Let me see some wiggle. Come on, let me see some. Yes, man! Yes! Oh my gosh, that was a good movement, guys. More moves than Jagger over here. Yes, man.
Gorgeous, everyone. Gorgeous.
How's it going on?
That's beautiful, guys. Oh, what a proud day, Nan. What a proud day. Finally got rid of her. Joking. Oh, yes, gorgeous. Look, don't show the bride up, Nan, okay? Look, it's so fabulous. Beautiful, guys. Well done. That's amazing.
Oh, my God.
Oh my gosh, lovely guys. Right, squeeze in, fill in those gaps. What a gorgeous bunch, look at them all. Guys, you look fabulous. Right, look at this way, my darlings. Oh my gosh, that is perfect.
Say cheese.
Cheese, where's the cheese? Where's the cheese? Where's the cheese? Have you got some cheese for me? Can I have some cheese, please?
Ow!
That was cute. Right, squeeze in everyone. Oh yes, love it. Beautiful. Only mum moved, but that's great. What a gorgeous family, guys. This is a lovely one. This is a gorgeous picture. I love it. Beautiful, everybody. Well done.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
You look beautiful, both of you. Oh, proud day, Nan. Yeah. Sora Murray, look at that. Don't she look good? Don't she look good? Oh, beautiful. I think she's got her looks from you, though. Gorgeous dive, well done. Perfect, well done. Let's have a look. Oh, yes. Oh, guys, what a proud day. Basically, today is your fault. If it weren't for you guys, we wouldn't be here, wouldn't we? Let's be honest. So that's pretty good going. What a gorgeous bunch. Lovely guys, amazing. Right, are you? Literally, summer just arrived. I love it. Right, put your arms around and get in there. Go on.
I know.
Watch the veil, watch the veil. Beautiful, guys. Gorgeous, guys, gorgeous. Was she a good girl growing up?
Yeah, she was, actually. Really good.
Mum's like, yeah, your dad's like,
she was born and she got
worse from there. Yeah, she was good. Devin, your face. No, I was good, actually. I have your fan. Beautiful, guys. Well, thank you, my love. Amazing, guys. Put your arms around him. Come on. That's it. Gorgeous. Yes, gorgeous, guys. Well done. Kyle, we know Kyle was a good boy growing up, don't we? Perfect, you guys, amazing.
Da Vinci felt like when he painted the chapel. Wait, is that Michelangelo?
Michelangelo painted.
Honestly, I can feel that. I can feel it. This is like, yeah.
Da Vinci did Mona Lisa, but please don't compare us to that.
Isn't she really sad?
Yeah.
Right? That's the whole point. She's like sad and like neglected. Right, darlings, looking this way. Oh, this is so good. Okay, everyone look over there. Everyone look over there and then back at me. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. The back at me was what I was working towards, guys. That was good. Back in the room. Beautiful. Right. Love it. Let's, Kyle, you can step out for a second. We'll just do the girls. Yeah, it looks like it. Honestly, I get asked at every wedding. So we're just like, that's your what? That's your what? Oh.
I am female.
We assumed you were gay. I get that.
None of us are thinking that.
Yeah, right. I don't mind. Campiness is goodness. It puts everyone at ease. It's better than going, yo, I can smile. Do you know what I mean? It doesn't work. Don't they look good though? Oh my gosh. Ladies, on three, I want you to give me Spice Girls 2021. Whatever that means to you, show me.
I mean, I want to do a girl power, but
whatever you want to do, whatever you want to do, I want to see it, whatever that represents to you. Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, three, two, one. If you want to be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Love it. Who's the scary one? None of you.
Oh, no, her. That one.
No.
Don't know what
I think
about.
You're all the gorgeous ones. Wait, that wasn't one of them. Okay, whatever. Right, girls, just everyone turning in towards Debbie, let your flowers hang low. Oh, it's like a Vogue shot. Love it. Oh, GQ. Yeah, straight faces, no smiling. Let's go. Oh, that's what I'm talking about.
Oh.
I can't not smile today.
I'm only joking.
Are you asking for blue steel?
Yeah, blue steel on three. Right, so look it away, look it away. Okay, ready? Three, two, one, go. Terrifying. Terrifying.
That was good.
That was good. That Papa Debbie was laughing.
10 out of 10 blue steel.
Little tiny bit scary, I'm sorry. I've got to be honest. Right, girls. Should we do a flower pump? In the air. Bosh!
Okay, yeah.
Just try not to knock out anyone next to you.
Sure.
Okay, are you ready? I want power in the frame. Okay? Ready? Okay, I don't know what that means, but just try it.
Okay, cool.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Three, two, one. Whoa! Alright, girls. Love that, love that.
Cool. Anyone else have that?
How about just one where you just...
I just had confetti fall everywhere.
Just squeeze in and give each other a bit of a cuddle. Go on.
I can't get in.
Oh, that's cute, girls. That's cute. Looks a bit like a scrum, doesn't it?
Well, that's a nice and fresh. I really like that.
Yeah, it's lovely.
Beautiful. I don't know who to look at. Just look at her.
Look at Sarah.
She better look at.
Can you get even closer? Just get your head. Oh, yeah, I love it.
Move the mail, move the mail.
Nice.
When I say guys, thanks, each year. So take a
I want a rugby team as well.
Oh, yeah. Do you play? Oh, wicked. Oh, that's cool. What position?
She's
a
winger.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, obviously a back.
I played rugby for a while, but then, play ice hockey. Similar kind of, it's still crap. Right, okay. Not really. I'm joking. We've been on contact for a year and a half. Guys, go back a little bit for me so we're like sideways on. That's it. Okay. What's this about? It's definitely. I'm not going to throw anything at you. Are you okay? Just, no, I'm joking. Stand how you want.
Oh,
you're
ready.
There's a Bentley now.
Yeah, probably one in my
hair. My legs are
getting well sweaty.
Right, look in this way, you lovelies. Look in this way, please. Oh, love it. Oh, that's amazing. Kyle, come forward to me like before. Maybe you can let go of everyone. Come forward maybe four or five steps. Keep going. Right, okay, that's good. Right, guys, when I say go, I want you to run forwards, throw your arms around him, give him a bit of a dig in the ribs or something, okay? Ready? If you want to just like full on elbow in the head, I'll end up.
Just not his head.
Don't do that because it's like wet all day. Okay, are you ready? Right, go for it. Come on, get him. That's it. Oh, full on assault going on here. Sorry, Carl, I didn't realise. Also, sorry, I didn't know you were right there. I just trod on your toe and you're trying to be cool about it. Really, you're like, my foot's gone. Oh my goodness me. Can you please give each other a little Bentley kiss? Go for it.
When you're in a bit. So Tony made me realise something, that Carl must really love my sister. Not because he's survived three lockdowns, but because he's given him another year to run away and escape. But he's still here. So what can I tell you about Debbie? When I met her, 31 years ago. The 22nd of May. She probably doesn't remember much. It's a pretty traumatic experience that she's just been through. I said, she probably can't remember much because it's a pretty traumatic experience that she's just been through. I remember it very well. I was pretty happy back then. It most exciting day of my life, age 3 years old. Little did I know, the next 31 years was going to be the most traumatic experience of my life. As you know, growing up, she was the naughty one. I was obviously the academic one. After leaving school, very disappointed that she only got a handful of A stars. She went on to successfully graduate and not one, but 2 degrees and get a dream job as a physio. When I say dream job, I mean the kind of job that involves running down 15 rugby players in the changing room. And it wasn't long until she told me one day she met a rugby player. As an older brother, I wasn't sure what to think. Naturally, hang on, wrong bit, to my head. Where am I? So, hang on a minute, fuck this up, am I? Growing up, although it seemed... although it may not seem at the time to us fighting, I was naturally quite protective of her at school. All of my friends were instructed to look out for her through secondary school. As an older brother, you're always very curious who she's texting and dating. Then I found out the latest guy was a rugby player. Now naturally, rugby players are pretty big lads, and yes, Carl's twice my size. Not only that, brown belt in kickboxing. So from that point, I just kind of hoped he was a nice guy, and fortunately he was. A few years went by, and I got received a Facebook message from Carl. The most mushiest message we've ever seen. Carl will never ever discuss this. Informing me that he was going to marry my sister. And here we are today. So Carl, I'd like to welcome you to the family. So I gave him this opportunity this morning to, it's not time to run away, but he still decided to go through with it and marry my sister. So I think you've both chosen very well on each other, and also it's a toast to Debbie and Colm.
Debbie and Colm!
So, unlike Craig, I've got it really short, so I'll try and not mess it up. Firstly, can I just say thank you for coming today. I appreciate it's been an absolute nightmare to get to this point, and I'm definitely going great. Try that. As in, I'm screwed if this goes quiet, because I'm quiet as it comes. All I can say is how beautiful you look today. And yes, you're stuck with me for life. And you will have to get used to stupid jokes like putting my finger. I've definitely got some thank yous to do. And just to start with, just how wonderful and how beautiful the bright... All the bridesmaids. How ugly the bridesmaids were. It picks and chooses. No, I'll try that again. No, all the bridesmaids looked absolutely wonderful today, and thank you for all the efforts done in the build-up to this, because I appreciate it's changed so many times. But nevertheless, absolutely wonderful to see you all. Groomsmen. Again, just but ugly, so. See, it works again. No, again, thank you so much for all the efforts. Obviously, sad that we couldn't have a couple here today from bridesmaids and groomsmen, but we know they're here in their own ways, so thank you to them as well. Anne-Marie, that cake is awesome. So good. So thank you so much for that. And then on to, well, brother and sister now, really, isn't it? Thank you so much for everything you've done. That goes not just through the wedding, but in the past 5 years, you've definitely been an amazing brother-in-law. And I might have said that from day one, because it's basically been like that. But no, thank you so much for everything.
Sounds like the Facebook messages. Gay.
Try and say something nice about me.
That's just your chance, don't. No, thank you so much. You've put so much effort into all of this, and it's been crazy, and I appreciate the amount of backs and forths and how much of a pain in the ass Deb's been to you. But no, thank you. Leave it as that. Obviously, again, it doesn't go without saying, parents, Bob, Carol, you two. Thank you so much for everything. You've been absolutely amazing throughout the whole process, and we wouldn't be in this spot right now if it wasn't for all of you. So thank you so much. I know. I'm not that useless. Yeah, I'll get there. We have a little something as well as a thank you to Carol. That's cool. Come on, Matt, you know. Chop, chop. And also to my mum. When Natalie gets there. So thank you. Thank you to all the suppliers from Plum Park, the photographers, Nando the videographer. You've all been absolutely amazing today and done phenomenal jobs. And I haven't seen anything yet, but I'm sure photography. As in, I've never had so many photos in my life. That's it. I'm done now for life. But thank you. And I said it from the start, but just again, a huge thank you to everyone that's come today. As I said, it's been a massive challenge to get this to happen. And I know we've all gone through so many different things throughout, but just thank you so much for being here today. It means the world to us. And that's me. Thank you.
Hi, let's see if this works. So I'm Kaz, and as a very traditional, you have a woman as your best man. So my speech is not short. I promised Gary it'd be under an hour. So we've got to be out by 7:30, so we should be good. So I did write that 12 slides. And I definitely didn't write it this morning. So I first met Kyle probably about 9 or 10 years ago. He rocked up to a training session, decided to help us out with some kicking and some fitness. Went very well. I'm not sure if he instantly regretted it, but I think the regret came very soon afterwards. We felt sorry for him. He was very, very, very shy and very quiet, and tried to get us to do things. Can you do a pull-up? No. Can you do a sit-up? No. What can you do? Nothing. Okay. That changed, I will tell you that. But he did come back week after week. He persisted. And his confidence grew massively. Like, he could tell us to do a pull-up, and we'd say no, and then he'd ask us again nicely, and then stay quiet. But he never lost his temper. He always kept his cool. And it's something we learned. He never ever gets angry. He just gets quieter. And he just waits and waits and hopes that you will just do what he's asked you to do. Sometimes that works. So over the training session, said we talked quite a lot because as a permanent member of the injury corner, he was always having to work with me, so we thought we might as well talk and make this a little less painful. So we spent most of our Wednesday evenings together, which you know, helped us learn more about him. And you know, he's actually a really just a nice, friendly person. Like, we had a lot of the guys come and help. Fred was one of them. That kind of came to help out and stayed for far longer than they really wanted to. And yeah, and then at some point he said that he could eat more cake than me. So challenge accepted, and it became known as Cake and Forfeits Day. So we decided to go to Costco. We spent about £40 on cakes and treats and cookies and things. We knew that we could demolish that. And we went to Willem, and we decided we'd do some workout and then have to eat a cake. It got to a point where we were both begging to do 30 tricep dips rather than eat another cookie. It was horrendous. Needless to say, I beat him on one of the challenges because he misunderstood the rules, so I beat him on pull-ups. Challenge winner. He won the other 9, shockingly. And we ate so much cake that when we had loads of leftovers, we couldn't eat them. And we couldn't eat cakes for weeks. Weeks and weeks. So we decided we were going to originally do that as an annual thing. Please, I'm on page 4 now. We decided that we would just hand them out to everyone else that came. So I think everyone that came to either of our houses for 2 weeks was just going to be fed cake. And then I learnt later when I went to his house, his mum makes the most amazing cakes. So many cakes. Have you all had a cake cut? Yes. So she's been training him his whole life, so he cheated. Like he would never have won if she hadn't have cheated him. I've done that bit already. So, blah, 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 blah. So then, we'd spend more time together, not just eating cakes. We decided to go to the cinema, we'd go to the gym. And if any of you have been to a session at the gym with Kyle, yeah, he says the words, fun, fun, fun. Does that ever mean fun?
No. Lies, lies, lies.
Never, never ever has the words fun, fun, fun been followed by something fun. The amount of times we've gone to the gym and he's done like pyramid of lunges and I couldn't walk. I actually physically couldn't get up from the machine and we just had to go home. It was just horrible. Next page. So yeah, so it's fun, fun, fun. So as I mentioned earlier, Brendan was one of the guys that came down and we kind of took him on as our surrogate son. So we made it our mission in life to make sure that he was going to become a man. So we helped him. So when he learned to drive, he had a few lessons in my car to help practice. When he was looking for a job, he wasn't looking for a job, we decided he needed a job. He came to work with me for a bit, and then the first day he rocked up with a lunch that was so big, it took up the whole lunch table, and he ate it all. All of it. It was just so, so much. But yeah, so even Brittle's son Ashley always asks if I'm bringing my son if we go on any day trips. So yes, he got a job, worked there in the summer. Oh yeah, Domino's. Have you seen him at Domino's? 3 pizzas and sides. And he did it all. Why does he work? I don't understand. Don't understand. So then we decided that we needed to get involved in Kyle's love life. No, it's not. Sorry, she's just reminding me of something. I'm not putting him there. So we decided, so between Andy, Beth and myself, we decided that he needed a girlfriend. Mainly so he'd stop torturing us at the gym. Because then he'd be spending time with someone else. And luckily, we did touch rugby over the summer. And he started chatting to someone, even ditching all his friends, so that he could walk to the car with this girl, which was Debbie. So it was so nice, because he would go there, he would chat to her, and we could just leave. Then didn't have to go to the gym afterwards. We didn't have to do anything else, because he was busy talking. It was wonderful. Yeah. See, I'm doing the same as you now. I'm like, I've said things I shouldn't have said already. Blah, blah, blah. Smitten, yes, they were smitten. Blah, blah, blah. Old people say smitten, it's fine. So we watched as their relationship bloomed, and I've written here, from a distance, because we're not creepy. And we were lucky enough to see them get together, move in together, get a dog. And I've never ever seen Carl happier when he realised he could fit a gym in the garage at his new house. Which I've had to do a workout in, and it's horrendous. Not fun, fun, fun at all. And obviously traditionally, on page 10, you'll be happy Gary, nearly done. Traditionally we tell embarrassing stories about the groom. So I promised him that I wouldn't mention anything really embarrassing. So I can't talk about the Ashford tour where he got so drunk he passed out in a tent with his feet hanging out. And I can't talk about the fact that on his stag do, he had to wear the most horrendous outfit and someone brought him a weighted vest to wear in 30 degree heat outside. Oh, Alex. So So I promised I wouldn't mention that, and I also promised that when I asked loads of people for their favourite memories of you, four of them were not the Ashford tour, and they just basically were like how crazy his gym sessions were, how much he eats, gym, fun, Ashford tour, like they're all that sort of thing, but I can't talk about those, because I'm being nice. But yeah, it's all new information. I bet none of you knew that any of that stuff before. So luckily enough, Kyle is one of those people you will always be count yourself lucky to know. He'll be there in an instant if you need him. On the last bit, Gary. And I'm so glad that Debbie was able to see past the crazy gym stuff, because I'm pretty sure that Andy, Beth and I could not find him another girlfriend. So you're stuck with him, I'm afraid, because we don't want him back. So at this stage, can you all raise your glasses for Mr. and Mrs. Gibbons?
I would know.
I'm not mean.
What
it? Yeah, that's fine.
Whatever tier you want.
I probably top wouldn't go top. I'd go middle. Otherwise, it's tips.
Top or middle, yeah. Top or
middle.
And then middle. I think maybe if you both hold on to the lead, that's it, guys. Love it. Can we have a little cake kiss, please? Oh, yeah! Love it! Woo! Should we give him a countdown from 20? Joke. From 3. 3, 2, 1! Woo!
Slides again!
Yes, you too. Do you have to eat something?
I can eat
it. Have a little bit, have a little shell. Go on. You've got to put it in his mouth. It's all romantic in here. That's it, shove it in there, yes. Perfect.
Terry's cake and forfeits.
Everything I do it for you.
Bigfoot.